In this video, we are going to review the pros and cons of Gibson assembly. The pros and cons are outlined here. Let's start with the pros. Gibson assembly is fast, with your typical PCR reactions ranging from 90 minutes to 3 hours, depending on the length of your fragment, followed by PCR cleanup reactions. The assembly reaction of 15 to 60 minutes is one of the quicker parts of the Gibson assembly protocol. Gibson assembly can be performed on any two or more fragments with a DNA overlap. There are no limitations imposed by the presence or absence of restriction enzymes. As we have mentioned, SnapGene supports the design of up to 10 fragment Gibson assembly constructs, and updated Gibson assembly reagents now claim to be able to combine up to 15 separate fragments. Gibson assembly is a completely seamless and sequence-independent cloning technique. You juxtapose the position of your fragments of interest in the design of your PCR primers. No extraneous nucleotides need to be incorporated. Despite sounding like the almost perfect cloning technique, there are some cons that need to be discussed with respect to Gibson assembly. The first is that it is another cloning technique that relies heavily on PCR. Like any other PCR technique, we are therefore at risk of introducing de novo mutations into our construct. Even with the highest fidelity PCR enzymes, there is always some rate of mutation. In addition, sometimes there are errors introduced at the recombination junctions due to the Gibson assembly reagents themselves. For these reasons, Gibson assembly reinforces the need to sequence verify any construct prior to proceeding in an experiment. Because we are creating regions of overlap between two previously discontiguous fragments of DNA, we need to use fairly long oligonucleotides as our PCR primers. This has two direct impacts on experimental design and flow. The first is the simple length of these oligos, makes them more expensive and necessitates purification as part of the synthesis process. This purification adds time and/or monetary expense to your experiment. Secondly, longer oligos are more prone to PCR artifacts, including primer dimers, homodimers, and stable secondary structures that might result in an inaccurate PCR product or inefficient amplification. When designing your oligos, be sure to run them through the appropriate commercial tools to avoid these problems. Also, be prepared to run your PCR reactions on a thermal gradient to optimize yield and specificity. Originally, Gibson assembly was not described as working well on fragments less than 200 base pairs in length. In response to this limitation, second-generation Gibson assembly kits, such as the Hi-Fi assembly kit from NEB, have been designed to efficiently assemble smaller fragments. The Hi-Fi assembly kit will also work with single-stranded DNA as one of the fragments being assembled. This slide recaps the pros and cons of Gibson assembly. To learn more about molecular cloning, visit snapgene.com.